그죠?
아, 무슨 일을 해라지? 이 웹방에서 하는 것 같아?
맞아, 그 오늘도 아주
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. against the number one.
But that.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. We are about to begin the service. We are going to start with the eulogy. So Joe and Martha, please come up for the eulogy. Those of us at the front of the church, please be seated and please be quiet. Thank you.
Death is an enemy. it blossoms to our loved ones, causes pain and grief and sorrow. And we all have appointments one which we cannot postpone. We have come to say farewell to the ones who, in one way or another, have made an impact on our lives. As I can see, she was their love. Flaw as she was called, was a woman of great quality, a fine specimen of womanhood. She was a kind and helpful person, a devoted wife, and a loving mother. She was hardworking, always finding something to do. She would attend to her patch of garden, working tirelessly, for she knew that a good crop would yield a good harvest. She was a breadwinner, diligently making sure that her children would get the best benefits. She was selfless, sharing whatever little she had. Though I did not grow up with her, yet I knew that she was a caring person. Whenever she would come to visit me, she never came empty-handed. I was a sickly child, and many people thought that I would not survive much longer. Whenever they saw me, they would say to her, "Only if I have what I need." She would determine that I must survive. She did all she could, and the love that she had was strong. She couldn't give up on me. Thank God I pulled through. Her efforts were not in vain. And so here I am today. I salute the courage. She was my hero. She's gone now. But one thing that I will remember with me forever is the expression on her face whenever I came around. That joy to see her son. She loved all the children just the same. She will be greatly missed. She was loved by many. And so let us not forget that the birds of the air will die. The beasts of the fields will die. All who walk this earth will die. But our heroes will live in our hearts forever. If I could write an epitaph in her honor, it would be like this. Taken from the book of Proverbs, chapter 31. Starting from verse 10 to 31. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is not of the ruin. So that each shall one have no needless boy. She will bring good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh gold and flax and worketh women in her hands. She is like a merchant ship. She bringeth her food from afar. She rises up also while it is yet night, and giveth meat to her household, and a portion to her maidens. She considereth the field and buyeth it, and with the fruit of her hand she planteth the vineyard. She girdeth her loins with strength, and strengtheneth her eyes. She perceiveth that the merchandise is good. Her hand goeth not out by day or by night. She layeth her hands in the spindle, and her hands hold the staff. She stretcheth out the hand to the poor, yea, she reacheth all her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow for her household, for all her household and clothes are scattered. She maketh herself coverings of tapestry, her clothing is silken purple. Her husband is known in the gates when he sitteth among the elves of the land. She maketh fine linen, and deliberate goods unto riches. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She opened her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. She looketh well to the ways of the household, and eateth not the bread of idleness. Her children arise up and call to bless her, her husband also, and he preacheth her. Many gods have done virtuously, but thou excellest them all. Favor is deceitful, and beauty is vain. But a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her the fruit of her hands, and let her own words praise her in the gates. She was a remarkable woman.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Thank you.
Thank you. On behalf of Father Albert Gabriel and I, Father Sixth
truth, I would like to extend sincere condolences to the family and relatives of our sister, Flora Lucien. I am new to Supra as a parish priest this unbelief my fourth week, and I was told that Flora was in church every Sunday. That even the first Sunday that I was there, the 15th of January, she was there, and she took sick after that, and the Lord called her home. So I'm thinking, I don't want to show it over. So we extend sincere condolences to the bereaved families. It was also brought to my attention that she was a market vendor. And market vending is something that's very dear to my heart, because my mother did some of this to raise us up, to send us to school. My mother was a hustler. And so when I knew that our sister was a market vendor, it rang a bell. It jolted me a bit, because that's what my mother did in some fashion, in some years, to raise us. My mother did all kinds of things. Market vending was just one of the things. So our sister served the Lord, and she served the wider community as a market vendor, selling the produce, whatever she had, and establishing that connection and that relationship with the customers. Brothers and sisters, in our gospel today, St. Luke reminds us that we must stand ready. Stand ready. For you now, are you ready? If the Lord were to say, today is the last day of your life, are you ready? Simon gave me a few concrete things. So he has said, very next you, la vie. Ou pas la vie, bébé. A sous la vie. Est-ce que vous parlez? Est-ce que vous parlez? Oui, oui, oui. Moi, je parle. La vie est un ordre. La vie est saine. La vie est sur la vie, la prière. La vie est sur la vie. Every day that God gives us, my dear brothers and sisters, we must cherish. We must cherish and savor every single day. Tous les jours, on y est, on a nous, c'est pour nous, tous les jours, on a une richesse qui peut riche passer l'argent, qui peut riche passer bien. Et le propriétaire. Parce que tous les jours, nous levons et que nous lui la soupe, le Saint-Esprit est de nous, pour nous, we must see what we need. To give God thanks and praise for every single day that He has given us. And we must also remember that every day that we live, we are getting closer to our own death. We get closer every day. January and February, whether we know that phrase, I just, you know, when someone told me what had happened, I just could not contain myself. I don't know people, but it was just heart-wrenching. So let us say,
we have to begin with the youth. We need adults who will
carry themselves as ladies and gentlemen. Right? The men who are there, I challenge you, would you consider yourself a gentleman? Ladies who are there, women, would you consider yourself a lady? When it comes to decorum, when it comes to etiquette, when it comes to modesty, when it comes to dressing, modesty, especially when we are here, they do form call their own. It's all these things we have to look at. Are we examples, living, vivid, vibrant examples to the children? These are the things we have to look at. How do children see us? Otherwise, if we are anything less, then we are shortchanging them and we are creating further monsters. Our spiritual lives have been eroded.
Like a soldier.
ministry of Flora, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, hear us.
Your mind.